In this video, I show you how you can make your own lip balm based on herbs and natural ingredients. Today, you will start with making your own lip balm. Before we start, I will first explain to you what the preparation tools and essentials are and which materials you can use best. I will tell you what the ingredients are, and then I will explain step by step how you can make your own lip balm. Let's start with the essentials. 2 Purex glass measuring cups. You are always safe with these glass measuring cups. You are going to heat them on a heat source, but because the glass is so thick, it will not collapse during heating, and if you then remove the glass from the heat source, you can do this with your bare hands and then you feel that the glass has not become hot. That is why these Purex measuring cups are so safe. If you're not yet in possession of a Purex measuring cup, before you go to the store, first open the kitchen cabinets of your grandma, because these are really the typical glass measuring cups used by grandmas. Wooden spoons. Always work with wood. You can use metals, but there are certain products that respond to metal, and these are mainly the more sour products. An unbleached cheesecloth. This is a rough cotton that is sufficiently permeable so that you can sieve with it. A plastic colander. If you have a stainless steel colander that is a bit older, then there may be bacteria on the underside of the mesh that you cannot get rid of, and the same bacteria can end up in your lip balm. Small glass jars. You can simply reuse old jars for this. Wash them well and afterwards disinfect roughly with alcohol. And finally, kitchen paper and a scale. Disinfect your materials with alcohol. Do not touch your products with your fingers or hands. You can still wash your hands so well, there can always be some acid left behind and this can end up in your products. In my videos, you will see that I wear gloves. This is not really necessary, but I think it's a nice idea to wear gloves. All the ingredients in the lip balm are edible, because what you don't want to eat, you also don't want to put on your lips. Ingredients. With these quantities, you can make 1 or 2 jars of lip balm. Yellow or white beeswax. Beeswax gives a glossy layer to your lip balm. Cocoa butter. Cocoa butter is widely used in lip balms and lipsticks. Cocoa butter gives firmness and it also ensures that the lip balm lubricates nicely. Coconut fat. You can use coconut fat from those large pots that you can use to bake with. Rice bran oil. Rice bran oil is an oil that is very well tolerated by many people and has hardly any allergic reactions. I have used grapeseed oil myself, which is also very good for the skin. You could use any oil that you want. It is best to use cold pressed oil because no heat is used in the manufacture of this oil and that is better for the quality of the oil. In the meantime, I have added the cocoa butter, beeswax and coconut fat to the oil. Essential orange oil. This gives a light taste and a nice scent to your lip balm. Dried marigold. Of course, you can also use fresh marigold if you have this. Marigold has a healing effect if, for example, you have chapped lips, spots or dry skin on the lips. Rose petals. These have a hydrating and soothing effect and gives a pink touch to your lip balm. Place a pan of water on a low flame. Place the measuring cup in the pan with water and let it warm au bain-marie. Don't let the water boil, but heat it to around 143 to 149 degrees Fahrenheit, because beeswax has a melting point between 143 and 149 degrees. Add the marigold. Because you also want the quality of your herbs in your lip balm, you are now going to add your herbs directly. Add the rose petals with a wooden spoon, not too many rose petals. We will only add the essential orange oil at the very last moment, because the smell and taste fade very quickly. But if you use the grated orange apple peels, then you can cover the top layer with this grated orange grater. Make sure you use organic oranges that have not been sprayed. Let it stand for a few hours so that everything can work well together, and stir occasionally with a wooden spoon. I will get to you in a few hours. Meanwhile, place the jars in a row one after the other. Place the cheesecloth and the colander and place it on the second Purex jug. It is time to pour over the lip balm. Teach yourself now to dry the bottom immediately. It may be that there are bacteria in the water of your pan. If it starts to leak, the bacteria can also end up in your lip balm. Carefully pour the mixture into the other jug. You can now see that the mixture will solidify again very quickly, so put the pan back on the fire. Stir gently through the mixture until everything has melted and is liquid again. Now add the drops of essential orange oil. Do this carefully with a spoon, because you can shoot very quickly. Gently stir through the mixture again. You can now smell the essential oil. The lip balm is now ready to be poured into the jars. Because you have placed the jars in rows, You can see that you can pour the liquid very easily with your can. Let the jars with the lip balm stand for a few hours. Keep a very small amount of mixture in your jug and put it back on the fire. You see that the solidification is going very quickly. A small dent appears in the middle, but you can straighten it again with the last mixture. If you have stickers, you can label your jar. You can set the date on when you made your lip balm, because the lip balm can be kept for around a year. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy making your own lip balm.